If you're watching this video, there's a good chance that you've seen some of my other videos. They're on the Fermilab YouTube channel, and make sure you subscribe to it, by the way. So you know that I'm all about particle physics. I make these videos to share these exciting topics with as broad an audience as possible. And I do okay with the adult population, but I got to wondering how well I was doing with teenagers. Luckily, I work at one of the most high-tech labs in the world, and we built a prototype encephalographitron, a powerful mind-reading device, and tested on teenagers while listening to me speak to see what they were hearing. Now, for anyone who's ever been a parent or a teen for that matter, the outcome is probably unsurprising. For instance, when I was saying something like, "This is the coolest thing ever. We can literally recreate the conditions of the Big Bang and understand how the universe came into existence." Can you imagine that? I can't even. What the kids were actually hearing was,
"Blah, blah, video games, blah, blah. Will he ever stop talking? Blah, blah. I wonder what's for lunch? Blah, blah, blah."
So I decided that I needed to try something new to reach the desirable, although somewhat frustrating, teen demographic. So I enlisted the help of Russell Farnsworth, a teenager and winner of the Rock the LHC video contest, to help me tell teens just how cool particle physics is. Now I should warn you, I picked him because he's totally awesome at this. And you can tell just by looking at him that he's super cool. Hi, Russell.
Hi, Don.
Nice outfit.
The difference is that I make it look good.
Yeah. All right. So let me tell you how to talk to people about science. Yeah?
I got this.
Are you sure? Because I could tell you some
hints. No, seriously. I got this.
You're sure?
I'm sure.
All right. Bye.
Man, I thought that guy would never leave.
I heard that.
Okay, let me tell you why particle physics is awesome. First, particle physics tells us how the universe works, from tiny atoms to how stars burn. Basically, if you know particle physics, you know about the science that everything else comes from. That's pretty cool. But it's not like these scientist dudes know everything. There are tons of things that they haven't figured out yet. One thing is called dark matter. Basically, it seems like there is a new kind of matter that nobody has seen yet. It doesn't interact with regular matter at all. You can't see it, smell it, taste it, hear it, nothing. And there's 5 times more of it than regular matter. That means somebody will discover it. It could be one of the old guys.
I heard that.
Or maybe someone from our generation will be the one. Then there's antimatter. Antimatter sounds like something from a science fiction movie, but it's totally real. If you combine a paperclip's worth of antimatter with regular matter, you get a huge explosion. So the mystery arises because of the theory of the Big Bang, and Einstein's theory of relativity says there should be an equal amount of matter and antimatter just floating around, but there's no antimatter and nobody knows why. That's another cool mystery. There are lots of other mysteries, and scientists are developing the technology to be able to answer those questions. It could take another 20 years to figure it all out. That means one of the old guys will design the equipment.
I heard that.
But we will be the generation that figures it all out.
So, how did it go?
Pretty good. I talked about a few things. You should have been there to take notes.
All right, maybe next time. So, are you totally stoked about science?
Yeah, pretty much. I'm still trying to figure out which thing to work on, but I'll be able to figure that out once I'm out of college.
Well, figuring out that question can be hard, but there are certainly lots of cool questions to answer. And here's the cool thing, there are still questions to ask. Being a scientist is pretty amazing.
Word.
That is cool. You know, you got to talk to my producer because I told him that saying word was utterly cool, and now you've proved it. So can you talk to him and tell him that, you know, I was right all along?
No, just kidding. Nobody says word.
Are you sure? Because I think it's really cool.
No,
I
mean, just no.
Well, can we at least agree that science is totally cool?
We can't agree that science is totally cool.
All right, high five. Now, can we also agree that I'm totally cool?
Sure. Let's go with that.
So you think it's funny to be tested on, huh? How about this? Or that one? Does this one feel good? No, it doesn't! What about this one? Huh? Huh?